The Bullard High Television Production presents The Best of Odd Thursday, Volume 2.
Mrs. Cluck, what do you have for us today?
Oh, good morning. I'm Mrs. Cluck, and these are eggs. They come in brown and white. Since eggs are a good source of protein and an excellent source of iron, myself and...
The incredible edible egg.
Who is this, Mr. Kookaroo?
Oh, why, yes, this is Mr. Kookaroo.
We will now demonstrate how to prepare eggs. Mrs. Cluck will show you how to make a scrambled egg.
First, you take the egg and you crack it and put it into the bowl. Then you add a dash of pepper and a dash of salt. Then you blend it all together. See? Then you pour it into the pan. And you stir it. And the finished product looks similar to this. Oh, it's so good.
Thank you, Mrs. Cluck. Now back to our program.
You're taking...
Teacher.
Now, I heard that you went to a baseball game yesterday afternoon. Now, I thought you were absent from school because you wanted to go to your grandmother's funeral.
I did, but she didn't die yet.
Oh, Mikey, and why are you wearing that tank top? It's cold outside today.
I can wear it if I want to. I learned that the law, the United States Constitution, guarantees everyone the right to keep bare arms.
Now, Mikey, I just hope I didn't see you looking at someone else's paper during the test yesterday morning.
I hope you didn't either, teacher.
Now, Mikey, let's forget that. Let's just go on to a math question. Now, say I lay two eggs over here, and I lay three eggs over there. Now, how many eggs are there all together?
Personally, I don't think you could do it.
Mikey, tell me, just what have you learned in school?
I learned that the law of the United States says every person can only have one husband or one wife at a time.
Okay, and what is that called?
That is called monotony.
Monotony? Well, then there most certainly must be a lot of monotonous people out there. Yes, come in. Oh, very good. A message about the talent show next week. Let's see. How many of you students out there would like to be in the talent show? Oh, very good. Yes. Okay, thank you. Thank you, young man. Oh, young man. Young man. Young man, who is your teacher?
Kathy McNamara.
Oh, Kathy, what a pretty name.
Don't let the name fool you. She grows horns at test time.
Horns? Young man, have you ever been sent to the principal's office?
I've been sent there so often, I have my own desk there. Sometimes we close the door and play poker with the secretary.
Poker? Oh, and who else do you play poker with?
Square Deal Lipston.
Square Deal Lipston? And just what kind of a poker player is he?
He cheats.
Cheats? Now, I find that rather hard to believe. And I just think there's a lot of people out there that just wouldn't think you're such good friends with Mr. Lipston.
Ah, what do you know?
Now, do you want to prove what a good friend you are? Just turn right around and say, hello, Square Deal.
You're kidding.
No.
I'm afraid to look.
He'll know what to do.
Anybody want to be a nurse?
Oh, great.
Go.
Sure looks like it.
What do you think of that?
I can't understand it.
Just goes to show.
What?
Can't judge a book by its cover.
What's that mean?
I don't know. I'm just a baby. I'm just born.
So am I. Goo, goo.
Where the river runs free, for a land through the green country.
This is Brad Stevens welcoming you to the WRS MGM News with Bill Sermon, Steve Scott, international correspondents, Lenny Saldana, Yvette Hames, local correspondents, Janice Liu, Sherry Ray, meteorologist, and Kevin Robinson, sports commentator. Plus a special mini show with Kim Miles and Gary Otake on Radcare. And now to Bill Sermon with the news.
Prices of beef and other foods have increased substantially in February and are adding to fears that inflation may be worse than expected in 1978, according to government figures Tuesday. Testing of marijuana for herbicides has given proof that many of Fresno's low-grade marijuana is being laced with angel dust to improve its power. And now to Stephen Scott with the rest of the national news.
The Sacramento rapist has just attacked his 32nd victim. Yesterday morning, he raped a mother while her two children were sleeping. A house in central Sacramento just got their garage made into a living room. It caught fire because of a careless smoker. The fire caused $1,500 worth of damage to the living room and $250 worth of damage to the neighbors. The firemen said that it only took 5 minutes to put out the fire. Now to the local news with Lenny Saldana and Yvette Hames.
Bonnie and Clyde, two miniature mules from Hickson Stables, helped with the groundbreaking for the $3.5 million Country Plaza Shopping Center on Blackstone behind Lugas Restaurant. It will be built on 6.5 acre lot. It should be finished by October. A Catholic education groups say Catholic schools are holding their own and may be more firmly enriched than ever. Despite court curbs on the aid they receive, there are 3,289 students now enrolled in 9,822 Catholic schools, down 76,000 students and 82 schools from last year. Now that Yvette Hames with the rest of the local news.
Additional studies requested by the state for proposed Red Bank and Fancher Creek flood control and recreation projects should be completed by the end of the year, announced Colonel Donald M. Oshai of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, Sacramento. The California Board of Rivers and Harbors recently reviewed a feasibility report on the project and then requested more hydraulic and hydrologic economic and field survey data. Of estimated total project cost of $44.7 million based on October 1976 prices, the federal government would pay $36.2 million and local interest $88.5 million. And now to Janice Liu and Sherry Ray for the weather.
Clear or partly cloudy sky with temperatures near or above seasonal levels dominated the nation's weather Tuesday. The only precipitation was rain covering much of Washington State and southern Florida. Rains also dotted areas from Ohio to western New York and from eastern New Mexico to western Texas. Afternoon temperatures in the 30s were limited to the northern section of the Great Lakes and northern Maine. Temperatures in the 40s and 50s prevailed elsewhere across the north, while 60s and 70s dominated the central and southern United States. Temperatures in the western third of the nation ranged from the 50s in the northwest to the 80s in the southwestern deserts. In northern plains, warmer temperatures melted the snow and caused floods, especially in parts of central Minnesota. Now here's my partner, Sherry Ray, with the local weather.
In Fresno and vicinity, there was variable cloudiness through Thursday with patchy morning fog. The highs will be in the 70s to low 80s, and lows will be in the mid-40s to mid-50s. Fresno's low today was 50 degrees, and the high today was 80 degrees. In the Sierra Nevadas, there were increasing clouds with a chance of showers tonight and Thursday. In Northern California, rain will be likely to come today. The San Francisco Bay Area was overcast this morning with a chance of drizzles. This afternoon, there will be variable cloudiness with a chance of showers tonight. And now to Kevin Robinson with sports.
The Kentucky Wildcats beat the Duke Blue Devils 94-88 in the NCAA championship. And O.J. Simpson finally got his dream come true. He was transferred to the West Coast to play for the San Francisco 49ers. And Spink's lawyer filed a lawsuit against the WBC for taking Spink's title away and giving it to Ken Norton. And Kareem Abdul-Jabbar scored 34 points to help the Los Angeles Lakers beat the New Orleans Jazz 108-103. In pro hockey, Atlanta beat Toronto 7-4. Pro basketball, Phoenix beat Portland 127-84. And Philadelphia beat Buffalo 149-118. For tonight, Milwaukee will play Indiana at 8:30. And New York will play Washington at 8:30. And Friday night, the Golden State Warriors will play the Indiana at 8:05. And here's Kevin Lyles and Gary Otake with the animals.
You can get a rat at many pet stores, but choosing a rat isn't that easy. First, it's better to get a young rat because an old rat is more likely to bite. Of course, a young rat will bite, but after a few days, it'll get used to you and very seldom bite. Second, the rat should be certified, meaning having all of its shots. Food, well, the food should be hard and crunchy. Alfalfa bricks is a good source of vitamins. However, if you cannot find these, hard dog or cat food is still good. Once in a while, soft food is all right, but too much will give your rat the runs. Your rat should not be kept in its cage all day. At least 10 minutes a day, it should be out. It may be hard to take it out of its cage, but it's for your rat's well-being. Remember, your rat should be exercised every day. Here's Gary Otake.
When you buy a rat cage, get one that sits with a space over the tray, not directly on it. This is so that the droppings will fall through to the tray and not stay in the cage. You should also buy a rat a water bottle. Get one that uses ball bearings, not a valve. Get one that is stainless steel, so this is so the rat won't chew the spout. They like chewing like they chew aluminum ones. You can get one at most pet stores. If your female becomes pregnant, separate her from the male or else he would kill the babies. Put some shredded paper or wood chips in the cage to keep the babies warm. Don't bother the mother when the babies are nursing. Just work around her when you clean the cage. Make sure you separate the males and the females when they are 7 weeks old, or else the females will become pregnant. Now back to Brad Stevens with the rest of the news.
This is Brad Stevens signing off for Bill Sermons, Dee Scott, Yvette Hames, Lenny Saldana, Janice Liu, Sherry Ray, Kevin Robinson, Kevin Lyles, and Dario Tunnel. Good day and good news.
Thank you.
Dungeons Code to Dungeons Deep and Cavernous Mine. We must do it at the break of day to seek the pale, enchanted gold. The dwarves of yore made mighty spells, while hammers fell like ringing bells. In places deep where dark they sleep, in hollow halls beneath the fells. For ancient king and elvish lord, there many a gleaming golden hoard is shaped and wrought, and light they caught to hide in gems on hilt and sword. On silver necklaces they strung the flowering stars, on crowns they hung the dragon fire. In twisted wire they meshed the light of moon and sun. Far over the misty mountains cold, to dungeons deep and caverns old, we must away or break of day to seek to claim our long forgotten gold. Goblets they carved there for themselves, and hearts of gold. Where no man dwells, there lay they long, and many a song was sung unheard by men or elves. The pines were roaring on the height, the winds were moaning in the night. The fire was red, a flaming spray. The trees were like torches, blazed with light. The bells were ringing on the dale, and men looked up with dragon iron, more fierce than fire, laid low their towers and houses frail. The mountains smoked beneath the moon. The dwarves, they heard the tramp of doom. They fled their hall to die and fall beneath his feet, beneath the moon. Far over the misty mountains grim, to dungeons deep and caverns dim, we must away or break of day to win our hearts and gold from him.
North Central Fire Emergency.
Yes, this is Mike Bayshore, and I think my mom just had a heart attack.
Okay, where do you live?
I live at 5600 North Palm.
Okay, and what is the phone number there?
It's 252-9307.
9307, and your last name again?
Bayshore.
Bayshore?
Uh-huh.
Okay, is she still breathing?
She's breathing slightly, but she has chest pains.
Okay, our paramedics will be there momentarily.
Okay, thank you.
What you have just witnessed is a simulation of an emergency paramedic call being received at the North Central Fire District's Emergency Dispatch Center. How can you recognize the signs and symptoms of a heart attack, and when are paramedics actually needed? Basically, a few of the signs and symptoms. Persons will have crushing chest pain, some shortness of breath, sweating, they'll be pale, and they'll be very uncomfortable and oftentimes belligerent. When you observe any one or combination of these symptoms, it is important to let the paramedics evaluate the patient and determine whether or not they require hospitalization. Immediately upon observing these symptoms, paramedics should be summoned to the scene. And in the meantime, if a person has stopped breathing or their heart has stopped, in which case they have a cardiopulmonary arrest, I'd like to show you a few things that could be done to help save that person's life. First of all, one must be sure the person is not breathing and not actually asleep. In which case, you can simply, as in the case of this mannequin, shake the person and shout, "Are you awake? Are you alive?" And find out if they respond to you. If they don't, tilt their head back in this manner, putting one hand under the neck and the other on the forehead, opening the airway and allowing the tongue to come off the back of the airway and allowing the patient to breathe. Look, listen, and feel. In other words, put your ear down to the patient's mouth and look at their chest. Listen for air moving back and forth, and feel for hot air as it hits your ear. If you do not look, listen, or feel any air, then you must begin rescue breathing or the patient will die. Within 4 to 6 minutes after a person hasn't had a cardiac arrest, brain death begins, and you have just that period of time not only to get the paramedics there, but to begin something called CPR, or cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Once the airway is secure, then give 4 quick breaths by placing your mouth in an airtight seal and pinching the nose in this manner. Pinch the nose. After four quick breaths have been delivered and the lungs are now full of air, find the carotid pulse, or the carotid artery, which is alongside the neck. Push deep into the groove and feel for a good 8 to 10 seconds to see if a pulse is there. If there is no pulse, you must now circulate the blood and get the oxygen moving to the brain, because if you don't, brain death is imminent. To do that, you must place your hands on the chest. Find the xiphoid process, which is an area in between the rib cage, and put your hand over the top of it in this manner. With the other palm of your hand, put it next to the xiphoid process, but never push down on top of it. Interlock your fingers and begin compressions at a rate of 1 per second. Compress the chest approximately 2 inches down, and if you're by yourself, you'll have to give 80 compressions every minute, followed by 2 breaths in this manner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Continue this procedure until paramedics arrive and do not stop. I must caution you, however, that you are not to do this procedure unless you have been certified by the American Heart Association or the American National Red Cross in one of their classes that are held regularly, because there are many, many more things that are involved. But this is an example of some of the things that are taught and how that you can save a life before the paramedic teams arrive. All too often, we arrive at the scene much too late. People call everyone but the paramedics. They call their family, they call the doctor, they call a hospital, they call a friend, they call a neighbor. And that 4 to 6 minute time clock continues to tick away. Paramedics in this county are stationed generally within just a few minutes of any scene in the greater metropolitan area. So if you get them on the road quick enough, even if you're not doing CPR, a person's life may be saved. Upon arrival at a scene, paramedics do many things, and they do them all at once because there is a limited amount of time. The vital signs are taken: blood pressure, pulse, respiration. An entire physical examination is conducted. The lungs are auscultated to determine how much water is in them, if any at all. And a complete physical exam, similar to the one the doctor will do at the hospital, is given to the patient, and then that information relayed to the hospital. In cases of chest pain or a heart attack, an EKG monitor, in our case from a LifePak 5, is hooked up, an example that I'll show you here. This is an actual heart rhythm. It's called an EKG, an electrocardiograph. The beats that you are hearing occur with every contraction of the heart and let us know that the heart is beating well. In cases of cardiac arrest, there will be no indication on the monitor, and an electric shock will have to be delivered via this unit known as a defibrillator. Paramedics are trained to interpret EKGs, just as the doctors are. In case there are problems with communicating this information to the hospital, then the paramedic must know what kind of EKG rhythm the patient is in so that they can determine the proper kind of treatment the patient should receive. This information is then all sent to the hospital inside this unit. This is called a CORPAC, or a coronary observation radio. It is an EKG telemetry unit as well. The LifePak 5 is patched through to the EKG telemetry unit, and this information is then telemetered to the nearest hospital facility or the one the patient desires to go to. With the flick of a switch, the hospital can not only receive an EKG but can hear every word that's going on in the room. A mobile intensive care nurse or an emergency department physician is on the other end of the line to offer their assistance. The paramedic and the doctor work as a team to determine the best mode of therapy and the best treatment for the patient to help the patient survive and to reduce whatever problems they might have. Paramedics carry nearly 36 different kinds of drugs. These medicines are located in the box down below. They come in ampules, preloaded cardiac injection needles, and in vials, and are available to deal with almost any cardiac emergency. Paramedics also carry a number of drugs for other kinds of emergencies, from everything from seizures for diabetics and for drug overdoses and a number of other problems that they can also handle, including trauma. Paramedics respond to auto accidents and deliver fluids and use other measures in order to save people's lives in cases of fatal hemorrhage. Intravenous lifelines are often started after this communication so that we'll be able to administer medicines through the veins directly to the heart. This equipment is located in a primary IV box on the right-hand side. Intubation equipment, so that the person can be properly intubated and air delivered to the lungs, is also located here. So once an IV is established, and if necessary, the patient intubated and ventilation continues, the patient is now stabilized, and if medicine is required in order to stabilize the person's cardiac rhythm or their mental status, then that is also delivered prior to the transport of this patient to the hospital. The patient, now stabilized, is placed inside a mobile intensive care unit and carefully monitored all the way to the hospital with the IV going, with oxygen and the EKG monitor running. The hospital is in constant communication with the paramedic team, and further medications may be delivered as well. In many cases, this will prevent a cardiac arrest from occurring. But in all too many cases, cardiac arrest occurs prior to the arrival of the paramedics, and what we need is time. So by people knowing that paramedics do exist and not only work in cardiac emergencies but a myriad of different medical problems, we are your doctors that make house calls, and we're in communication with the doctors at all times. And hopefully in this situation and in others, that we'll be able to save lives in the field and decrease the amount of heart deaths in the country nationally.
It was a British study by one.
They all ran out to the farmer's house. She cut up the tails with a carving knife. She did everything.
As wicked could be, but oh, he... Is there anyone I'm supposed to look into specifically?
I look into the camera. Is there something that they can cue me into what camera to look into? Watch their hand. They'll...
What camera you want to open on, Danny? Okay, look into this one.
This one, Mary?
For now, yeah.
Alright.
They're just fooling with the music right now. It's pretty cute.
Ho for the pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee. He was as wicked could be. But oh, he was perfectly gorgeous to see, the pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee. His conscience, of course, was as black as a bat, but he had a floppity plume on his hat. And when he went walking, it jiggled like that, the plume of the pirate Dowdee. His coat, it was crimson and cut with a slash, and often as ever, he twirled his mustache. Deep down in the ocean, the mermaids went splash because of Don Dirk of Dowdee. Moreover, Dowdee had a purple tattoo and stuck in his belt where he buckled it through, or a dagger, a dirk, and a squizzamaroo, for fierce was the pirate Dowdee. So fearful he was, he would shoot at a puff, and always at sea when the weather blew rough, he drank from his bottle and wrote on his cuff, the pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee. Oh, he had a cutlass that swung at his thigh, and he had a parrot called Pemberton Pie, and a zigzaggy scar at the end of his eye, had pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee. He kept in a cavern this buccaneer bold, a curious chest that was covered with mold, and all of his pockets were jingly with gold. Oh, jing went the gold of Dowdee. His conscience, of course, it was crooked like squash, but both of his boots made a slickery slosh. And he went through the world with a wonderful swash, did pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee. It's true he was as wicked can be. His sins outnumbered 103. But oh, he was perfectly gorgeous to see, the pirate Don Dirk of Dowdee.
No music.
No music. Did we hide out inside?
Yeah!
Oh, did we duck to pull out your eye?
No! $100! That's what he pulled out of me.
What did he charge for visit?
$100 for first visit, $50 for second visit, and $5 for third visit.
Very nice. Here I am again for the fifth time. If I come again, you'll owe me 8 cents.
Well, what is the trouble with you?
Well, I really don't know, but every time I eat a heavy meal, I don't feel so hungry after.
Are you the doctor?
Yeah.
Are you his nurse?
Yeah, I am the nurse.
His nurse? Is doctor sick?
No, I'm a train nurse.
Oh, you do tricks.
What are the doctor's office hours?
Oh, 1, 3, 3, 6, 12, 9, 11, 4. Many hours.
With such hours, he must be a horse doctor.
Did you do as I told you? Drink water 30 minutes before go to bed?
Yeah! But I was completely full after drinking only 5 minutes.
Would you recover entirely from the operation?
Yeah. No, Dr. Von Snort says I still have 2 payments to make first.
Oh, by the way, I remind you of that little bill I sent to you last week.
Oh, excuse me. I will go now.
Well, you told me not to worry about anything.
I will go now. Bye, Zibe. How much will my next operation cost?
Well, I think they might give you the cut rate.
Yeah.
I am sick of trying to cure these neurotics all the time. I am working with an experiment that is, let us say, a secret.
But is it here, Doctor?
Well, I think it is time to show you. Come, Batman.
Oh, no, Doctor. I am so afraid.
Ludwig! Ludwig! Come and see here, Ludwig. Where are you? Where's that mad monkey? Ludwig! That mad monkey be not eat all my bananas. Now maybe chase my patients, no? Alas, we will have much happiness, no sponge jugo.
What does Dr. Van Snort talk about?
Behind this curtain is that mad monkey. I will change him into a great bionic person. He will be the greatest person the world has ever seen. And I will be rich. I'll be famous. Miss Van Stugel, give me the candle. I will go look for him.
Will Dr. Van Snort catch the monkey? Will Nurse Fräulein Van Snugel catch Dr. Van Snort? What about Dr. Von Schnurz's patients? Will they catch and load? What about you? Will you catch the next program? Tune in tomorrow, channel 13, at Golden High Speed. As you